I'm Pete,
and we're the Buffalo guys.
For 6+ years we've been here, every Tuesday at 2 o'clock. It's a wide variety. It's a lot of the what we call the Great American Songbook, but it's pretty much anything we want to do. It could be Tin Pan Alley, it could be Broadway shows.
Gershwin.
Could be, the Gershwin, Cole Porter, Hoagie Carmichael, any of the great composers. Yeah,
we haven't still got
learning. Our Bon Jovi and our Alice Cooper makeup down yet. We're just a very small bit of what takes place here. I mean, when you think about everyone that walks through that threshold, those doors coming in, there's a variety of experiences, emotions, needs, desires, emotions that bring them here. We're just, again, a small part of the great teamwork that happens here at this great, great facility. We watch people walk in, stop, dance, sing along with us, forget just for a moment why they're here. And if that's what we can do and what we can offer, it's all worth it.
Kind of enjoyable to sit here and watch people that when they walk in the front door that are sometimes very petrified for what they have to face or one of their loved ones have to face. And they're tired and scared and they're very nervous. And when they walk in and hear music, whether it's us or a piano, there's music here all day long. And just to walk into this beautiful lobby and hear music just really kind of allays a lot of their fears, and they walk away, at least temporarily, a little more refreshed and willing to face the rest of the day. I've been a platelet donor here for 30 years, and I started because one of my coworkers at Mead Vapor, his sister was dying of a kind of a rare stomach cancer, and he asked me if I'd give blood. I thought it was whole blood. I didn't know it was platelet. I didn't know what platelets were. And I did, and 2 weeks later he said, could you do it again? And I said, well, sure. And then 2 weeks after that, she finally succumbed to the disease, and so did my best friend at work. He died of the same cancer about 2 years later. And I just stayed with it. I've been doing it for 30 years, and every 2 weeks, it's my contribution to society, I guess. I don't do much else.
When I retired, I called Danny at his office, and I said, would you like to play a little guitar together? And he said, yeah, come on down. So we got together and we worked up a few tunes. And when I felt like it was okay to perform, for me, I said, Danny, we're gonna play at Roswell. And like next Tuesday or whatever it was. And he sounded a little dubious, but that was 6 years ago and we've done it every Tuesday since, pretty much. I did this for my own reasons, that I got a bigger kick out of this than anybody else does. I kind of inflict my music occasionally on people. But I get the feedback, and it's so gratifying to realize that you've touched anybody's life, and in a pleasant way. And you don't hear it all the time. You see them walking by, you see the looks, but that's enough for me. I've been delighted to be here. It's been a wonderful 6 years, and I hope it's 20 more. Thank you.
I like sunsets, fireplaces, and walk along the water.
And
pink lemonade. I don't drink, I don't smoke, and I shine my shoes in front and crease my pants on the side. Or is it front? I'm not sure.
Well, turn around, let me see. We're not paid to be funny.
That's right. This is serious stuff.